Okay guys, welcome back. Okay, welcome back. This is consumer behavior class, right? So I've been teaching consumer behavior, okay, for quite some time. In fact, this is my favorite subject, okay, consumer behavior. I think what some of you have met me before, okay, from the other classes. But you may be asking why consumer behavior, we place consumer behavior somewhere later in your studies, because consumer behavior requires certain form of analytical thinking. Okay, it requires some form of maturity in your argument, in your thinking, and your analysis. So that's why we place consumer behavior a little bit further in your studies. As I said, this is my favorite subject. Okay, my favorite subject. I emphasize this subject more than the other subjects. Right. Before I start the class, I would like to talk about your assessment. Okay, your assessment. For this consumer behavior, the same as the other subject. Hold on, let me answer this question. Salam, do we have team for consumer subject? Right. Yes, please check your field. Right, for consumer behavior, okay, for consumer behavior, the same as the other subject is 60-40, meaning 60% is your individual work and 40% is your final exam. For consumer behavior, the 60% would consist of your individual assignment, 20%. So your individual assignment is also your midterm exam. Okay. Then your group report is 20%, and your group presentation is 20%. Okay. So if anyone asking, when is the midterm exam? So midterm exam is your individual assignment. So the moment you hand out your individual assignment, then I consider that as your midterm exam as well. Okay, because the question bit the individual assignment, the question is quite tough. Okay, quite tough. The same standard as exam. Okay, for your midterm exam. Now, let's talk about your individual assignment. Okay, if you open your, can you open your BLE? Okay, because I want to talk about your individual assignment. Please open your BLE. Okay, open your BLE. Semua dah open ke your BLE? Have you open your BLE? Open your BLE right now. So, for your individual assignment, first you need to read the background of the article. All right, there's an article about athletic shoe market. Okay, athletic shoe market in the US. So they give you some sort of information. Okay, so this individual assignment is basically talking about market segmentation. But unlike the other, okay, the other subject whereby you only can you only talk about theory, you're only talking about how to segmentize your market. For consumer behavior, we are now moving towards analysis. Okay, we're going towards analysis. This is All right. Now, when we move towards analysis, this individual assignment is basically what it is, because if you read the question, it gives you the data. Okay, if you read the data, and then there are a few stages. Okay, few stages that you need tasks. Okay, that you need to you need to do in order to answer the individual assignment. Okay, task one, you need to do some sort of calculation. But the formula of the calculation are given there. Okay, and you need to calculate, do some basic calculation. And task two, three, and four, okay, is where you need to from the numbers, okay, from the numbers that you from the numbers that you receive, okay, from the numbers that you receive from your calculation from task one, then you can you need to start doing the analysis. Now, why I give you this kind of assignment? Because most of the time, we only, okay, for those who just joining, okay, for those who just joining, please open your VNE, look and open your individual assignment, and please switch on your camera. Okay, please switch on your camera, because those who have not switched on their camera, I'll consider that you're not attend the class, right? Okay, then you open your VLE, look at your individual assignment. Okay, individual assignment. Those who just join, siapa tu? Aimi Norain. Dan nampak tak awak punya individual assignment? Nampak? Dekat VLE.
Nampak sih.
Okay, cool. Saya, tapi saya tak nampak awak. Saya nampak peace. Nampak pokok. Where are you?
Kejap saya, saya tinggal siap ni.
Okay. Alright. Okay now. Why? Because most of the time, we concentrate too much on the data. Okay, but when we do the data, okay, when look at the data, we seldom give meaning to the data. Okay, because I would like to give you some sort of understanding that data is meaningless without meaning. So the one who give meaning to the data, the one who give the numbers to the data, or give meaning to the numbers, is you. Okay, as a marketer, you just you not only have to get the data, you not only have to look at the numbers, but you need to give meaning to the numbers. Okay, so this individual assignment is doing exactly that. Meaning, first they would require you to do some calculation. All right, complete the whole numbers, the whole table, and then from the numbers, they would require you to give some meaning. Meaning you need to analyze that numbers. So this individual assignment is doing that, actually. Okay, doing exactly that. Meaning you must not only know how to crunch the numbers, you must also need to be able to give interpretation to the numbers, do the analysis. Do the analysis, okay? Because most of the time when we do market segmentation for other subject, We learn about how to segmentize based on ethnic, based on age, based on demographic, based on psychographic. But basically, that is there is analysis behind that. How do you come up with that decision? How do you make the decision whether to segmentize your market based on age? How do you derive to the decision to segmentize your market based on ethnic, for example? Okay, and then that is the question. Okay, how to segmentize that? How do you derive to that decision? And, is there any question?
Macam tak ada apa je.
Macam tak ada apa je. Apa? Siapa tu? Ya, ada masalah. Siapa ada masalah kat sini? Who got problem here? Siapa ada masalah?
Emilia.
Ah, Emilia. Yeah, what's your problem, Emilia?
Telefon mute.
Mute. Awak mute ke apa? Awak terlupa mute. Okay, make sure kalau awak nak mengutuk saya, mute dulu, okay? Alright. Now, Emilia, awak dah nampak tak awak punya individual assignment kat dalam VLE?
Ada, sir. Sorry, tapi tak mute.
Okay, tak apa. Okay. Alright, no problem, no problem. Now, Emilia, switch on your camera ya, Emilia. Now, so you need to submit, okay? You need to submit your written assignment, your individual assignment on or before 11:59 of 19 October 2020, Monday. Okay, meaning you can submit to me today, tomorrow, up until the end of 19 October. Alright? Your written assignment can be in pages, words or PDF format. You submit your assignment through VLE. Okay, and the individual assignment will amount to 20% of your coursework. Alright, any question about your individual assignment? Emilia, ada soalan?
Sir, saya tak jumpa lah.
Awak tak jumpa? Apa, individual assignment?
Yes.
Dia dalam VLE bawah sekali.
Bawah sekali ada assignment kan? Ada satu.
Oh, okey, ada saya. Sekali.
Check kat situ. Okey. Now, ada soalan?
Tak ada.
Emilia, Sofia, ada soalan?
Tak ada. Tak ada.
Yang table ni, sir. Macam mana nak kira, sir?
Apa dia?
Yang table ni macam mana nak kira dia?
Oh, table tu macam nak kira dia?
Haa. Yang saya kata suruh complete the table.
Yes. Awak tengok kat task one.
Okay.
Okay, dia kata fill in the missing value, correct?
Wait.
And then dia kata use the available information in the table to calculate the missing values. The formula to calculate the missing value are as follows. Okay, 1.1.
Oh, okay.
Okay, kalau satu waktu kat table tu 1.1 somewhere dekat atas.
Okay, calculate. Okay.
Kan? So nak kira 1.1 tu, dia ada bagi the formula.
Alright, okay.
Formula dia. So you use the formula to calculate 1.1.
Kan? Alright. 1.2
pun sama juga, dia ada bagi formula kan?
Okay. So ikut 1.5 sampai, okay.
So everything ikut formula tu lah kan?
Pardon
dah
me?
Ada formula dalam tu.
Yes.
Semua dah ada formula dalam tu, kita ikut je.
Alright. Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, and then based on that figure, then you can answer the subsequent question. Okay, the subsequent question is more about analysis of what you have calculated. Because when you do the calculation, then you get the whole picture, right? And from the whole picture, then we will ask you how to analyze, how to segmentize. How do you derive to the decision to segmentize your market? Okay? Alright, so meaning to say from this exercise, from this assignment, then when you go out, you know how to segmentize your market. You don't just decide, oh, I wanted to target young people. But then what is the rationale of your decision to target young people? Is it because of some data that you have, or is it because of your hunch, or is it because you think that that is the most common sense to do? So in marketing, yes, you sometimes you need to do to use your hunch or your what is called gerak hati, but it need to be backed up with data. Okay, it need to be backed up with numbers. Okay, that's why you do research. You do market research, then you get the data, then you make decision. Alright. So for this assignment, although you need to send before 19th of October, but I would recommend, or I would advise that you do it early. So you, because the question is quite tough. Okay. The question is quite tough, especially the calculation is quite easy, but the analysis part is quite tough. So if you do it the night before, okay, you can, but it's at your own risk lah. Alright. If you read the VLE where I put the WhatsApp group numbers, right? I already put there. If you wanted to message me, wanted to call me, yes, you can, but make sure during the working hours. Don't text me. If you text me at night, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, I will just reply you the next day, next working days. I'm an old person. Okay, I sleep early. I need my sleep. You guys young, of course, you guys 10 o'clock still young, all right? Me 10 o'clock already groggy already, so I need to sleep. Public holiday, Saturday, Sunday, I was usually in the forest, dalam hutan. So I won't be able to reply to you. Kalau aku kat rumah pun, I won't reply to you. I need to work-life balance. I think you should do that too. Okay. Any question about your group assignment, your individual assignment?
No, sir.
Oh, yeah? Okay. I just would like to remind about the use of VLE. Okay, but the use of VLE, not only for my subject, okay, not only for my subject, for other subjects as well, before you come to the class, okay, whether it's online or face-to-face, please check out your VLE before come to the class, okay? Especially when I already put in my VLE, please join the Microsoft team group early, not after I have started the class. All right, because I still receiving requests to join the class. Okay, okay, never mind. This is the first class. I still give chance. All right, but for my other classes, please make sure that you are on time. Okay, you're on time. Read your VLE before you come to the class. All right? Because this class, okay, is very... I need to hear your thoughts, okay, on the subject matter. It need to be in the discussion form. Because for consumer behavior, it's a subject that learning about human, okay? Is learning about, basically is that it's not that hard, because you are human, I am human, so basically what we are learning about ourselves, but we try to learn about our own behavior, okay, our own behavior, and is that is our own behavior reflects the market out there. Okay, so for this subject, I would recommend that all of you not only read the textbook or read the whatever material that I put in the VLE for your extra reading material, I would suggest that you make further research on your own. Okay. I would suggest you to go out, okay, and observe the market behavior. Okay, you can go to the mall, you can go to the pasar raya, you can go to the mini market, and you just observe how people make a choice. You go outside and you watch television, for example, see how people advertise and how that influence your behavior. All right, so you need to observe, okay, the human behavior. And just like any other subject that I teach, I would encourage you to watch YouTube, watch Netflix, videos, right? Not only on the reading materials, because you need to look a lot at your social media, for example, okay, and see how people advertise advertisement in social media, influence consumer behavior, how people try to influence behavior through social media, how do people try to influence consumer behavior or your behavior through the mass media. So all this that you need to observe. Okay, it's not that for consumer behavior you just read the book, read the whatever in the VLE. No, yeah, you need to widen your scope. You need to widen your horizon. Okay. Nur Ashraf, awak ada masalah? Awak ada soalan?
No, so far, so I'm gladly to hear that you'll be encouraging students to hear information from other sources. It'll be such the textbook, sir.
Yeah, where are you? I didn't see you. Please switch on your camera.
Apologies, sir, because my camera is having problem with my laptops.
All right. Okay, for those who just join in, please switch on your camera, yeah? Okay, because for me, if you don't switch on your camera, you do not attend the class. Because I need to see you, right? I need to see your reaction. I need to see your behavior. Your expression, your facial expression. Okay, whether you understand or whether you are there. All right? Now, any question about the individual assignment before I go to the group assignment? Tak ada? No question?
No, sir.
Alright, so we move on to the group assignment. For group assignment, okay, you open your group assignment. There are two attachment, okay, to that group assignment. One is the question, another one is the article. Okay. So you need to read the article first to understand what this assignment is all about. And then you open the question. Okay, the question. How are you supposed to answer this group assignment? Now, basically, this question, okay, this group assignment, you need to come up with a first at the on week three, okay, in week three you need to come up with a write up your plan, okay, your plan to answer this question. Okay, your plan to answer this question. Okay, this is in week three. It carries 20 marks from your total report. And in week 13, okay, week 13, then you give the full report. Okay, week 30 you give me the full report. So why I do this, because one, I need to make sure that all of you have a group members. Okay, I learned from the previous session up until the last week, then suddenly there's 1% or 2% do not have any group member. So after this class, then you go and find yourself group members. Right. So after this class, find yourself a group member. Okay, you can use the WhatsApp group platform to find your group members. I would prefer somewhere between 3 to 4 people in a group. Okay, 3 to 4 people in a group. 5 is already too lot. Okay, there are only 18 of you. So 5 people in a group is too many. So I would prefer 3 to 4 people in a group. But maybe one or two group maybe have 5, but that's a anomaly. I just need 3 to 4. So in week three, you need to come up with a write-up on your intended outline topic. Okay. This if you read the article, okay, this question is about testing how brand selfie shapes consumer behavior. So your job, okay, your task is to test how are you going to test whether how brand selfie shapes the consumer behavior. So consumer behavior here can be intention to purchase, can be intention to engage with the social media of the brand, or intention to use the brand. Okay, so that is consumer behavior. So you need to tell me in week three your group members, and how are you going to tackle, how are you going to approach this question. Then I would be able to give you feedback. Then after week three, you do the final report, and you need to report to me in week 13. Okay, week 13, then you need to present. Okay, you need to present your finding in week 13. Okay, and the presentation will be 8 to 10 minutes. Okay, for one presentation. That week 13, your second report and presentation will carry another 30 marks. So 50 marks, all right? So any question? This 20 and 30 is only marks for your group assignment, not for the total coursework. Okay, any question?
No, at the moment, sir.
Maman Amin Rafiq. Any question?
No, sir.
Switch on your camera. Okay. Right. Alright. Okay. If there's no question, ni siapa yang baru masuk tadi ni? Ada soalan tak? Siapa yang baru masuk tadi? Ada soalan?
Sir, is there any wrong for me to use any platform for the presentation besides PowerPoint, sir? I'm just asking. Prezi.
Yes. But the presentation still using Teams, okay, still online. Doesn't mean that you need to present through PowerPoint. You can use whatever whatever method that you think you able to deliver your presentation effectively and efficiently. There's no such thing as it must be in PowerPoint presentation, but the presentation must be going through online, okay, through Teams. All right.
Thank you, sir.
Puteri Nurjana, ada soalan? Puteri Nurjana? Puteri Nurjana, where are you? Puteri Nurjana? Alright, okay guys. For the purpose of, when we attend online classes, attendance is not the main purpose. Okay, the main purpose is for you to understand the subject. But to understand the subject, you need to attend the course, the online class. So that is the purpose. We have learned for the past two semester when we do online classes. Students have the tendency to just participate, meaning not log into the class and being somewhere else. That's why I ask you to open your or to switch on your camera to see whether you're there, because it reflected in the final exam. Okay, it reflected in the final exam. When you just log in, then you do something else. Okay, I would count that as attendance. Okay, so if I that's why I ask you to switch on your camera. I will ask question to see whether you are there. It's not to punish you. It's not something. We all adults. Okay, we all adults. As an adult, we know right and wrong. Okay, we know our obligation. But this is again behavior. Okay, behavior. This is exactly behavior lah. Right, behavior. But we need to do this because we need to make sure that you understand the subject. If you're just here for the sake for being here, okay, you just log on, then you go something else, then you don't listen to the lecture, then first, I don't consider you as you attend the class, and secondly, that reflects your behavior lah. Okay, since we are learning about behavior, so this is the kind of behavior that we're going to you're going to face when you go to the job market in the future. Right now, that's me talking about the ground rules. Talking about ground rules, I understand that our class is 12 o'clock during lunchtime. Okay, so I don't mind if I see you eating, vaping, drinking, no problem. But no sleeping lah, janganlah sleep. Buka kamera nampak awak tidur, not nice. Kalau menguap 2-3 kali tu normal, okay? Sebab saya pun dulu pernah jadi student. Two hours lecture for me is like punishment lah, okay? Alright, so sometimes saya menguap juga dalam kelas. So kalau awak menguap tu, I don't take offense. Saya faham perasaan anda. I've been in your shoes previously. Even now. Okay, even now. Alright. Ada soalan for your assignment? Ada soalan? Siti Nur Syazwani, ada soalan?
Tak ada, sir. No, sir.
Alright, okay. Semua tak ada soalan. Memang tak ada soalan ke? Kau ambil suara aku cakap je sampai 3 jam.
Tengah proses.
Ada soalan. But mungkin bukan sekarang.
Talking about the lectures. this lecture, you can interrupt me anytime you want to ask question, and then in the middle of the lecture, there will be question for you to answer to keep you awake. And then at the end of the lecture, there will be some discussion that you need to do, some activities that you need to discuss about the matter. And then I will give you question for you to do your own homework. That one homework, no markah, okay, no markah. But it will guide you on do your own revision, because when you wanted to do revision, you need some guide. You don't have to read everything, right? So that question that I give you at the end of the lecture, just to guide for your revision. Okay, kalau awak nak hantar balik pada saya untuk semak, boleh. Tak bagi pun tak apa. Tak ada markah. Okay, but it is for your own good. And at the end of the lecture, I'll give you a case study for next week. So that case study, you go back and read. Okay, go back and read, and we're going to discuss next week. Okay, when I say discuss, means really discuss. It's not me giving you another lecture. Okay, I won't give you answer. I just need you to give me the answer. What you think about the case study? Okay, siapa tak datang, siapa tak prepare for case study, sila keluar daripada kelas ini. Lebih kurang macam itulah. This is, no, that it just reminds me of my old lecturer. Okay, who yang sangat garang macam singa betina. Alright, now, any question about the lecture? Ada apa nak tanya? What is your expectation ke? So, no, sir. Yang panggil apa, sir? Syarif, my expectation is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, I need to up to your expectation.
What's your opinion, sir, about the gaming industry, sir? I mean, back in the 1980s, the gaming industry had been booming since the launch of the Nintendo Super Mario, and also it's given impact towards the society till today. But I think so far in the class, there's no discussion about the gaming industry until now. Like, I'm just giving a suggestion. Based on, because the gaming social allowance also as their business structure that will also the influence the consumer behavior themselves.
No, when you have games, right? Games, video games, for example, they're not only now restricted to games. Okay, now it is also a channel or a tool for marketer to reach consumer. What we call branded entertainment. Okay, branded,
true,
meaning people who play games, but still from the games, marketers can reach all these gamers to communicate their product or their brand. And gamers also, okay, shape the consumer behavior in terms of you have all this, what we call this, it creates electronic babysitter. You know what's electronic babysitter? You go to any mamak stall or you go to any restaurant and you see parents with young kids. The parents want to eat. They do not want to be disturbed. They give iPad or they give phone to their children. So the children just watch the iPad, children just watch the smartphone. Play games ke, watch YouTube ke, watch Baby Shark ke. That's what we call electronic babysitter. So it change the behavior of the consumer in some way. All right. Okay. Good question. Any other question before I go to the mundane lecture? Ada soalan? Kita tanya lagi. Puteri Nur Jannah, ada soalan? Puteri Nur Jannah.
No, sir. Okey je.
Okey je. Awak ke mana tadi, Puteri Nur Jannah?
Tak ada line.
Tak ada line. Okey. Right. Oh, so, okay, another thing, kalau if you got any problem, okay, any problem with the line ke, you kena bagi tahu saya lah. Okay, so I can take this up with the, apa ni, with the management. Awak kat mana, Nur Jannah, yang ada line ni? Where are you?
Rumah.
Rumah awak kat mana?
I Soho.
Saya nak tahu location.
I Soho, Shah Alam.
Shah Alam? Shah Alam tak ada lain. Alright. Tapi tak boleh nak cakap lah sebab Geni Campus ni berkadang tak ada lain juga. Kan? Alright. Now, if you open your BLE, okay, you look at week 1, Framework for Consumer Analysis. Then there is a PowerPoint presentation there. Can you open that one? The title is CB dash introduction. So you open your, okay, my lecture is you need to open your own, okay, your own slide. I won't show in this, I won't share in this session. Why? Because the moment I share the slide, I can't see you. Second reason is I want to force you to open the VLE. So you can see what is in VLE. This is consumer behavior juga. Alright, force. You need to be forced to do something. That is behavior juga tu. Right, semua dah dapat ke?
Sir, saya punya dia jadi PDF lah, sir.
Yes, mine is PDF as well. Yeah.
All right.
The reason I use PDF because I use Keynote presentation. Keynote is for Mac. So kita punya VLE dia tak cater for Mac. Dia tak Keynote, dia tak cater for Keynote for Mac. Sebab Teams ni dia masih lagi zaman dinosaur. Okay, so to enable you to see my presentation, I need to convert that into PDF. Dah jumpa tak?
Jumpa, saya jumpa.
Jumpa tak Siti Nur Syakira? Siti Nur Syakira, you there? Ino Syakira reply. So saya tak boleh join meeting. Jumpa. Ni Siti Nur Ain. Okay, jumpa. Right. Why Siti Nur Syakira? Your something wrong with your camera and your mic? Siti Nur Syakira. Kenapa dengan mic dia? Siti Nur Syakira reply. I'm using my phone. If I open the camera, cannot see other things. Okay, Nur Syakira. Okay, let me reply to Siti Nur Syakira. Next class, can you use laptop? All right. Now, for me, I'm quite informal, yeah. So you don't. Siti Nur Syakira reply. Okay. All right. Thank you. All right. For me, I'm quite informal. Okay. So. So don't be too formal with me, right? Okay, don't be too formal with me. So you although I'm quite lepak, I'm quite laid back, I must say, but deadline is deadline, ah. Deadline is deadline. That's the only ground rules. Okay. You can call me Syarin also, I don't mind. Alright, now consumer behavior, foundation of consumer behavior. Now, what is consumer? What is consumer? Consumer is those consume meaning those who use something. Well, if you look at the textbook, okay, textbook. Farida ni cakap pula pula. No Farida sir, sorry, I hear your class since started, but saya guna phone, laptop, saya hang, ada problem masa start. Jadi, so I cannot open the video. Alright. Technical problem. Okay.
Sorry sir, for the technical.
Oh, okay. Dah okay ke problem awak tu?
Phone ni, just saya buka kat phone je. Dia punya camera still stuck.
Ya ke? Alright.
Sorry sir.
But then macam mana awak attend the other classes? Macam ni juga ke?
Semalam okay je. Lepas tu hari ni stuck.
I like your attitude. Mengalami
sometimes, sometimes I get the same problems as hers when during the class itself.
Yeah. I understand. Sometimes technical thing happen lah. Sebab I think on Monday pun tiba-tiba ada wifi problem dekat Geni Campus ni, saya tak dengar apa awak cakap. Kan, I understand your problem. Okay, so if I ask you question, you have got some technical problem to answer through video and all that, you just text dekat apa ni, yang chat tu kan. So I know you're there lah, so you understand. You are following the class, but you just unable to reply. You can't see it. You can reply through text. That is okay with me. Okay. I'm not fussy on that. Right. Now, if you look at the slide, it says that a consumer means a person who identifies a need or desire. A need or desire means for consumer, when we as a marketer, when we promote something, either a product, service, or ideas, it have to satisfy the needs of the consumer. Because without satisfying the needs and wants of the consumer, that consumer will not buy your product. Okay, so that's why consumer means a person who identifies a need or desire. Makes a purchase. Okay, so he makes a purchase, he buys your product, he buys your service, he buys your idea. And then dispose of the product during the three stages of consumption process. We're going to talk about the three stages of consumption process later on in this class. So you just remember that a consumer is someone who buys your product because he needs and wants your product. And he makes the purchase and dispose of the product or the service or ideas. Right? Then next slide. What are we going to cover in this class? You can see, okay, that first we're going to talk about the consumer behavior as a process. We're going to learn about people. Okay, where are these people come from? We look at the demographic, the age, the ethnic, right, the gender. And then how that demographic will influence your segmentation strategies. And then consumer, you have two, people and business. Okay, B2C, business to consumer, and B2B, business to business. All right, so consumer, you have two types, consumer, the people, okay, the people and also the business. But business also buy from another business. And then we talk about choices. All of us, Okay, all of us have choices. Nobody can force you to do anything. Nobody can force you to come to this class. But you make the choice to come. Thank you. Nobody can force you to study. But you make the choice to study. So we need to learn why people make certain choices. Why? Because, well, later on lah. Ini about introduction, right? Needs and wants. What are the needs and wants of the consumer? What is your needs? Sometimes we can ask ourselves, aku nak apa? What do I want? What do I need? And differing perspective of understanding consumer behavior. This is a different perspective or different ways of we going to approach consumer behavior. Different way of we analyzing consumer behavior. So this is a bit more philosophical. Motivation to consume. What motivates you? Okay. What motivates you to do something? We as a marketer, we need to know what motivates certain people to buy something. Why? Because if we know that, then we can use that motivation to drive the consumer to buy our product. And technology and culture, type of consumer behavior studies. Now, when you first heard about consumer behavior, what comes into your mind? What comes to your mind? Muhammad Nur Iman.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Muhammad Nur Iman. Oh, bila you dengar tentang consumer behavior, what do you think? Ini pasal apa sebenarnya?
About user. For example, we want to buy something. So, the user behavior.
Okay, why we need to understand about the behavior, Muhammad Nur Iman, salah nama pula.
Sorry, sir.
Muhammad Nur Iman. Kenapa yeah. We learn about Muhammad Amir Rafiq? Sorry. Saya nak tanya Muhammad Nur Iman. Muhammad Nur Iman, why it is so important that we understand the behavior? Kita belajar belajar behavior, apa hai?
Because it's about target market.
About target market. Okay, Muhammad Amin Rafiq, what's your take on this? Why it is so important that we learn about the behavior?
Because we want to know their consumption pattern, and then how they spend their money, on what items they mostly spend their money. We sort this out, we find all this information so that we can apply a better, effective and efficient business planning.
Betul juga tu. Okay. You wanted to sell your product to the consumer, correct? As a marketer, we wanted to sell our product, service or ideas to the consumer, correct? Tapi consumer ni siapa? Who is the consumer? Nurul Najihah, siapa consumer?
Pelanggan tu. Orang yang membeli ataupun menggunakan kita punya produk services.
Orang yang menggunakan our product and service. The keyword is what? What's the keyword? I don't know. Orang ah, the word.
Orang.
Orang is siapa orang ni? You and me. You and I. Is orang, right?
Yes.
So do we have characteristic? Do we have attitude? Do we have behavior?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, correct.
I do.
By understanding human, okay, by understanding human, then we know how to what? Manipulate that behavior. macam let's say for example, let's say you suka K-pop for example. You suka K-pop. Then you know that a lot of people suka K-pop. So as a marketer, then you go and sponsor this K-pop artist. You bagi brand jadi ambassador. Why? Because you know that the behavior orang sekarang ni suka tengok K-pop, suka tengok K-drama ke what not, tengok BTS ke, you know that. I'm sure some of you are BTS army here. And so let's say Pepsi, for example, dia sponsor BTS. Okay, dia sponsor BTS. So tak ke follow-follow BTS ni akan beli Pepsi juga?